special guest panellist today is, of course, Fiona Coote. She captivated the nation 30 years ago when she became the country's youngest heart transplant recipient at the age of just 14. So, Fiona, let's talk about that. How long had you been waiting for?
Look, I hadn't been waiting very long at all because from the time I got sick to the time I actually had my transplant was less than 4 weeks.
Wow.
And I was only put in hospital the week before, and that week I was on total life support. So the wait wasn't very long, and that's why the media played such an important part in me actually getting my transplant because I only had, you know, days.
Do you remember how you felt? Were you frightened? Because it was very pioneering, wasn't it?
Look, I was thankfully unconscious. My parents were no doubt terrified in my family. But I knew about it all afterwards, but certainly at the time I had not a clue, which was a very good way to be. Having my second transplant, you know, I cried all the way to theatre because I knew what I was
in
for.
How old were you then?
I was 16 when I had the second.
Oh, wow.
Why did your body reject the first one?
Yes.
Because you're very much, I think, everyone feels like they know you in Australia. You've got that beautiful face and we sort of have followed your path along the way, and with that lovely smile that you still have.
Yeah.
And so what is life like for you now? You say that you had that second transplant at 16, and a lot of the drugs that you have to take can cause quite an impact too, can't they?
Look, they can. Look, I'm in such a fortunate position because we now have so many different medications that we can take. Some of them are anti-carcinogenic, and that used to be one of the big problems for transplant recipients. So my life these days is great, and I take quite a few different medications, but only really small doses. So, you know, transplant patients who come through now don't have the big moon phase and acne like I had because they just don't use that much of that particular drug. So it's fantastic. They just fly.
And this is kind of a sort of a stupid question, which you'd expect coming from me, but do you feel, because of the extraordinariness of this, that do you feel pressure that you have to do something extraordinary with your life that you can't just be, because, you know, you're just a normal person like the rest of us. Yeah. Do you feel kind of like that Saving Private Ryan thing where that anxiety that so much has been done for you, oh my God, I've got to, you know, I've got to, you know, fly to the moon, or I've got to discover penicillin.
Until you ask the question.
And if you weren't, why not?
Yeah. Look, I feel, I guess, a sense of wanting to give back and wanting to do well for the cause, not only for St Vincent's, who have looked after me so wonderfully, but also for organ donation. You know, we have so many people waiting for transplants, so I really like to be able to help in that area. And then there's also the research institute, the Victor Chang Cardiac Research Institute. You know, how can I not support them?
Yeah.
And why do you think there's a reluctance among so many Australians to donate organs? Because we're not very good at it. And there's always a need for more. There are people waiting for life-saving operations.
Look, I think it's not a matter of people not being generous. Many people want to be an organ donor. The thing about organ donation is there's so few people who die who you need to die in a hospital setting. So, you know, if we die at home, you can't donate your organs. So it is quite a special thing. Less than 1% of people who die can actually be an organ donor.
Because you've got to get the organs fairly quickly.
Because you've got to die in a hospital, So people are generous.
And there should be an opt-out system, shouldn't there? This is just insane. I think there are some moves towards it in New South Wales, but there should be a thing where everyone is an organ donor unless they specifically say, no, I don't want to be, and that's fine if you've got religious reasons or whatever, that's cool. But otherwise, because I reckon everyone here would want to be an organ donor, and I reckon less than 10% of us have actually gone and signed up and said, yes, I want to do it.
Well, they've done the research, and they say, yeah, it's apathy. It's a big part of the reason why. Such a special story, and so great to have you on our panel. Thank you very much, Fiona.